and TDK, audio and video cassette. Hi, welcome to Sky Dutch Football. Tonight we have a big match in Holland, Ajax against Sparta Rotterdam. And the coach of Sparta Rotterdam, we know him, is Mr. Barry Hughes. Barry, a young team at this moment, Sparta.
Yeah, we've got a young team, but it's, I must say, in this season we've played these two games and they've done so very, very well, and we've got Ronnie van den Berg back, and you know that's a big improvement with a young team because he's got experience. He's only 25, but he's an experienced player.
And they can beat Ajax.
Well, that's what we've trained for, and that's what we work for to beat Ajax. We've planned well. We've seen them play, and we've got an awful lot of confidence. And I was just talking to the boys about different things. If we keep the concentration, we know what we're doing. We've got a very, very good chance. Yeah.
You're from England, Barry, but Stapleton isn't playing today with Ajax. Why?
Well, it's a pity because I know Frank personally, and I've seen him by Arsenal and Manchester United, and he's been in two games, and you've got to give a player a little time to settle in, and he's a good striker, Frank. He's an Irishman, but anyway, you know, you have good players in Ireland as well.
Anyway, you've got a star in your team at this moment, Jules Elleman.
Yeah, well, Jules, a very, very good player. The only thing you've got to be careful, he doesn't get too much publicity, and they start to think, well, he's a great player. He's the type of boy that he'll always, you know, be calm, and he just lets it go fast. He's got a tremendous lot of talent. I just hope that it can
be a big star.
Yeah, if he's a little bit not physical, and you saw it against Essex and Hague, they were putting a player right next to him. He'll have to get used to this. The more they write about him, the more they're going to mark him. Eh?
When we are talking about the defenders from Sparta, they have to play against the strikers of Ajax. What about Mr. Knell?
Well, Andro, he's a very attractive player. You know, he's 70% attacking and 30% defending. But everybody says, oh, he's got to defend more. But I said, well, let him go. He's like a young boy who's swimming in the deep end. He's got to learn it on the football field. And he's going so very well at the moment. And the crowd like to see him attack, so I said, go on, attack. The way it is.
Okay, let's make one thing clear. When you beat Ajax, I get your head.
Well, yeah, as soon as you give me some champagne.
Okay, see you, Barry, bye.
So here are Ajax back in the Netherlands since their first two league games, both won. They've been in Barcelona for a mini tournament, which has certainly been financially worthwhile. Now they face a Sparta team they beat here 6-2 last season. Well, Jan has been checking on the Ajax approach today, and down on the pitch he's talking to defender Ronald Spelbos.
Hi, Ronald.
Hi.
Playing against Sparta today, it's the third match in the competition. What do you think about the game?
I hope we win.
We have to play against the new star from Holland, Jules Elleman.
Yeah, I've heard, but I don't know much about him, but maybe I can find out in the game.
Okay, how was the tournament in Barcelona? You had a good time?
Oh yeah, it was very warm, but we played good. And I hope we can go farther with it.
Okay, good luck. Okay. See you. Well, here he is, Mr. Knell from Sparta Rotterdam. You have to play against the famous strikers from Ajax.
Yeah.
You afraid of them or not?
No, why? Because they're all human. They've got two legs. So do I.
You do, eh? Yeah.
Yeah, so do I.
You have a young team at this moment, Sparta Rotterdam. Yeah. It's nice to play in Sparta.
It's a terrific team.
But you know, you can be a star in this team.
Maybe, yeah.
You have to.
because you can't say you will be a star. I've got to learn a lot. So how old
are you now?
The future will tell us. I'm 19 years.
Ah, you've got time.
So, yeah.
Okay, good luck in the game. See you, Ed.
A very humble Andro Knell, and as Barry Hughes, the Sparta coach, was saying, he's being asked to swim in the deep end, making his mistakes in the glare of First Division football.
Well, here he is again, Mr. Sørensen. Are you playing today, Jan?
No, I'm not playing today. I had a bad game on Sunday against AZ, and we went to Barcelona. I had some troubles with my hamstring, so I'm 100% fit now. But Johan has chosen to play another team, and that's life in a in a big club, eh?
Okay, but go ahead.
That's true, no problem.
Okay. What about Frank Stapleton? He isn't playing too?
No.
From the beginning, but how does it work with him?
Well, I'm not sure. I think the problem with Frank is that I think he has to get settled down first. And for him, it's more difficult to find the Dutch way of playing football because he's used to 15 years in England. So I think he'll be all right if when he gets into the good rhythm. There's no problem.
You know Sparta very well, eh?
I know them. I've seen them a couple of times, but I don't know them that well. I mean, we know most of the players. We know the way they play, but we just haven't... I think we have a good fight on our hands today, so...
Barry Hughes told us I beat Ajax today.
Yeah, Barry Hughes always talks, you know. I don't think... You can't get surprised about that. He wants the team to win. He wants to have a big crowd in, and... I think that's all right as well. Can't say anything.
See you, Jan.
Okay. Bye.
So we are waiting for the big match between Sparta Rotterdam and Ajax Amsterdam. Martin Tyler, go ahead.
Thanks, Jan. Johan Cruyff taking his seat in the dugout. And this is the side he's chosen. No Sorensen, no Stapleton there amongst the substitutes. No Arnold Muren. He's away in Austria trying to shake off a virus. The one summer signing who is on view is Henny Meyer from Roda. 19 goals for him last season. And there's a place for the 22-year-old Scotsman, Ali Dick, whose progress here has been hampered by injuries. Sparta's side does rely heavily on youth, as well as Canel, as goalkeeper Ed Tachui, and 21-year-old Yul Elleman, who scored 3 goals against Utrecht here last weekend. Experience in the likes of Weinberg and Ron Vandenberg, with the first half just underway. And Sparta in the red and white striped shirt on a wet afternoon. The referee is John Blankenstein. And the first free kick he gives is for a foul on Ronald Lenkek. And the clearance there from Ali Dick, who started his professional career with Tottenham Hotspur, but didn't really make the grade in London. Elleman forcing the throw, which he thinks is his, but it goes to Ajax and Sonny Siloy. Sparta have made an excellent start to the season, beating Utrecht here 6-2, and then holding Den Haag in The Hague 1-1, but they're in trouble now. But Bosman's header rocketing out off the bar. Bosman, who really has been preferred to Stapleton as a genuine central striker in Johan Cruyff's side for this match, and almost justifying that decision there. And Lenkek opting to take the shot early, but dragging it well wide. That's an interesting ball from Wouters that has got the goalkeeper for a second in two minds. 20-year-old Ed Tachui, ever present last season. Sparta, basically a side of part-time players, and relying heavily against the pulling power of the bigger clubs like Ajax and PSV in producing their own talent. Pitschka. This is Wouters. Just ran away from him at the moment he was about to shoot. Across from Meyer. Bosman trying to make his presence felt in the air again. But a positive charge off his line by Tachui. Well, the crowd have really taken to Andrew Knell. With the Ruud Gullit dreadlock hairstyle. With the perm, Danny Blint, a former Sparta player. He settled in well in his time with Ajax. Ajax played 2-1-2, beating Roda at home 1-0, and then winning in Alkmaar against AZ 2-1. And the scorer. Both those games, as we look at Aaron Winter, been the Dutch footballer of the year for last season, Frank Rijkaard. But here's Siloy. Wouters. Here is Rijkaard. Playing further forward in the Ajax formation today. Anikic trying to provide service from the left. And Wouters in a holding position, really, in front of a line of three defenders. Lind, and he took too long. It's Ellerman who's away. What can Sparta come up with here? Circling in the middle, Ellerman wants to go his own way. And Barry Hughes has to look back in disappointment. Wanting it to run. In fact, it's held up on the soggy turf, but it ends as a goal kick. This really is a season where the potential of Ajax, one feels, must be fulfilled in the Dutch league, boosted by that win in the European Cup Winners' Cup. They won the Dutch Cup again. But the likes of Aaron Winter, who's given the ball away then, has to move from the promising youngster class into the rounded product, really, in the next year or 18 months. And that's deflected from Winter's shot. And luck with Sparta Rotterdam, no doubt about that. It came off the cant, I think, and then off the post. Menzo outside his area, but finding a way to go in, and then not wanting to pick the ball up. Always a crowd pleaser. Wouters. Fischer really in the Arnold Muren role. And away goes Dick. That's where Fischer wanted him to be. But Andreessen came across as the covering player. The Sparta give it away. Witzke. Wouters hit it beautifully. And De Gea just thrust up his hands for the blur of the ball, as he must have seen it, but got it over the bar for the corner. Taken by Meyer. Rijkaard. Might drop for Dick, but he was aware of the player sliding in, the Sparta captain, Frieder Hoff. But in the last instance, the memory will be of that save by De Gea from Wouters. Jan Wouters, who is an unsung hero really for Ajax, gets through a tremendous amount of work. Lynn. Operating really wide on the right at the outset, where he's in direct confrontation with young Andro Cannell, the 19-year-old. Ellerman. Free kick to be taken by Ed Riederhoff, who combines his football with work in insurance. Van der Berg. They haven't had so much of the ball, Sparta, but in the first half so far they've had one or two interesting moments, but mostly it's been a tale of some desperate defending and one or two pieces of absolute good luck. And now it's Lind who joins the Ajax attacking force. It's coming from all directions, really.
Help me! Rieder Hall.
Well, in that advanced position again. Hellerman close to him. And getting behind Ajax is Van der Berg. He's rejoined starter for this season from Groningen. And it was a testing cross that Lenkeek headed over. Stanley Menzo having to change his mind there and caught in no man's land.
Well, Spellbos.
And now Winter. Spellbos, that's neatly done. And again, De Gooi keeps Sparta Rotterdam alive. Lovely interplay between Spellbos coming from the back and the live Aaron Winter. And Alistair Dick takes the corner. He can't get it beyond the near post. Vichka. Wouters. And the early cross from Meyer wasn't a good one. It only found the head of Berkling. Van der Berg, a suspicion of handball then. But play on, said the referee. And then the whistle had to go for offside.
Valpers.
And Sparta working hard to stop Ajax making progress and forcing the back pass from Vichka.
Deloy.
He's got Dick outside him and in the end used him as a decoy. It was a foul by Older Rikerik. And here is Dick. Bosman was trying to set up Rijkaard. Didn't quite get it right.
Here's Rieder Hall.
And it's a Sparta throw of Henny Meyer.
Ajax have chalked up some heavy scoring victories against Sparta in recent seasons.
Almost 2 years ago they beat them 9-0 in Amsterdam, but it's not been that way so far. Although they have made the chances. Winter, Meyer. Now Vichka. And Dick. And Rijkaard slipping away from Rieder Hall. Well, it's the end product that's been lacking for Ajax. In a first half that has been goalless, but not without chances for the team that finished runners-up the last two seasons. Half-time, Sparta 0, Ajax 0. Welcome back to Rotterdam. Another intriguing battle between these two clubs. Rather similar to the meeting in the Dutch Cup last season, which went to a penalty shootout, and Stanley Menzo became the hero for Ajax that night with a series of marvellous saves when Sparta had several opportunities in that shootout to eliminate Ajax. As I was saying in the first half, of course, to remind you again that Ajax did go on to win that Dutch Cup. And they really should be in front here. This time it's Rijkaard. Guided across beautifully by Bosman. An opportunity goes a-begging. Deloy. Bosman going through the middle. Support from midfield from Rijkaard. And the
been plenty of opportunity for Danny Blin to gallop forward. Oh dear, oh dear. Yes, it says it all, the manager's expression. And this time the culprit was Bosman, when it just needed an accurate tap. Hellermann. Well, it was another little indication of the considerable promise of Yul Hellermann. Anderson, the defender, confronting Alistair Dick, and so far, really, in his career for Ali Dick, it's been potential rather than fulfilment, just as it was in that little episode. Came into prominence as a Scottish schoolboy international. Deloy leading the charge this time with help from Reichardt. And Cannell with an important interception. At times looking in a different class in possession, but then at other times wasting what they've worked hard to get. And Sparta are hanging on to a share of the spoils, but Barry Hughes wants to make a double substitution, Feinberg and Birkling being replaced by Van Stey, number 12, and Schurhausen, number 15. Frank Stapleton still can't get into the action. Blin. Vichka. Well, Sparta's ambitions at the moment, totally based on defence. Bouters. And Meyer almost made something then. Cannell had followed him into the middle. But really it was the type of ball that defenders should have dealt with. Played straight into Henny Meyer with no real angle on it. Asking a lot of Meyer to have to turn 180 degrees to get a shot in, but he almost did it. Back from Andreessen. Good control of a greasy ball by Danny Blin. Time it's the cant in the way to deny Meyer the opportunity of making something from that cross. And there's a lot of pointing, a lot of organising going on at the back for Sparta. Pinter. Vichka in the Arnold Muren style, trying to whip the ball in. And just buying his side a little bit of time was Van der Berg, as Ajax call off Alistair Dick and bring on the much more experienced Jan Sørensen. Just I suppose, some sort of worry for Ajax. The amount of the ball that they've had, but they might get a little bit complacent in their defending. Their concern at the moment is in the face of a long throw, which is headed out by Siloy and hit back with some power and not too far away by Andreessen. And for once, Ajax came second in the pursuit of the loose ball. Sørensen. Now Vitschke. Very much the pattern as it's been. Ajax seeking the opening. Sparta at full stretch as Knell was there. Bosman. There have been one or two really telling headers. Here's Rijkaard. Once more, that killer touch in front of goal eludes Johan Cruyff's men. Well, Andreessen kept calm. The crowd were panicking a little bit, and they're worried again, the home support. But Bahoui, yet again, equal to the test. Very promising young goalkeeper. Siloy. Van der Berg. Wanting to play it left all the time and waiting for the advance of Knell. That's a great cross on the run, but Wouters brought calm for Ajax. Delbot. De Meyer resuming his duel with Andros Knell again. Those who say that Knell is a little bit vulnerable defensively will have some ammunition that time. But again, Dakoui picked off the cross. The message is clear. Johan Cruyff is not satisfied. He's got one more substitution if he needs to. And it looks like Johnny Van Skip. Right. Neatly played. And Ajax turning on the style in the middle of the field. There's been plenty of that. But they really need to do it nearer the Sparta goal. Vitschke. And allowing Andreessen to come across. And it's Rijkaard who's going off for Van Skip. Track back, and Lenkic was bundled down, but where is the crucial question? There was a push by Winter outside the area, a cynical piece of defending and spotted by the referee. Here goes Aleman. Good save, the goalkeeper's side of the wall. Menzo would expect it to come directly that way and get a good sight of it. And the goalkeeper involved again from Lenkek's header. Sparta suddenly finding a second win. And their supporters responding. The corner to be taken by Jule Aleman. rescue by Canal. Gathered by Van Skip. No room to work close to that touch line. But he's got a free kick, which Ellerman tries to stop him taking quickly. Deloitte. Well, who'd have thought when Ajax got such an early grip on the match that the destiny would still be in doubt this late in the game? The reason for that really is a combination of things. Ajax have been sloppy in front of goal. Sparta have rolled up their sleeves and battled to try and bridge the obvious difference in class between the two sets of players. And there's been some excellent goalkeeping from Ed Dachoy. But Meyer could beat him here. And had that pass been squeezed to Bosman, it would have been the clearest of openings. Instead, it's Ellerman getting the better of Blind. He's got Lenkake up with him. He's faced by Spelboff. It deflected. Lenkek says off an arm. The referee ruled it must have been another part of the anatomy. And that's a foul by Storkhausen. And it's a storming finish that's had Barry Hughes hopping about on the touchline. With the corner, Belbos couldn't get there. Ellerman did brilliantly and he's onside. It's Lenkake against Menzo and he's beaten him, and Sparta have a goal 10 minutes from time with a classic piece of counter-attacking. Ellerman did brilliantly, and then Lenkake, with a long, long way to go, kept his nerve. Van Steen. And here's Ellerman onside again. A little clip over the goalkeeper and past the post. What a turn up. Ajax, supreme for so long, are struggling. One down, and so nearly two. Bosman flick. Ellerman. And Van Steen. Almost identical to the goal. The timing of the break was perfect. Van Steen looked for the same side as Lenkek had used effectively. And Bouters caught out of position now. Riederhoff. Sparta not content just to keep the ball. Canal. Ellerman, it's two, and that surely means the victory. He's made one, and now he's scored the goal that has given us a sensation. Ajax trail 2-0 with 2 minutes left. And they're singing in the stands, and the orchestrator is Barry Hughes himself, the British coach who spent so many years in Holland. his second spell in charge of Sparta, but this one of his finest hours. Binta. And no way back for Cannell. So these Sparta players, most of whom have to go to work tomorrow to their other job. You might have picked up the message from Barry Hughes, keep working. It's work that really kept them in the match against technically better opponents. And then suddenly, even before Lenkek sprinted half the length of the field to give them the lead, Sparta seemed rejuvenated. Maybe they just believed that the fates were going to be with them here. They'd survived for so long. And they weren't prepared to settle for just 1 point. But Bosman is there. But it fell to the wrong foot of Vitska. Well, he doesn't look too disappointed. There have been checks on the referees. Watch, and he's blown the final whistle. Johan Cruyff and his players are losers today. Deserved winners are Sparta Rotterdam. Barry Hughes, one of the most extrovert coaches anywhere in the world, even when things aren't going so well. But he can really conduct the choir now on a memorable afternoon for him and his team and their supporters. But I wonder what Ajax make of it all. And Jan Rietman is down there trying to find out.
Hi, Johan. What happened in this game? Well, you don't destroy your opportunity. That's the first place. But the second that worries more is that a lot of people think they're very good, but they don't do it on the field.
They have to learn a lot.
You've got to be a professional.
Next week, PSV, Eindhoven. You have to do a lot of work, Johan.
Yeah, well, normally it works just itself.
Okay.
The papers will do tomorrow.
Good luck.
Okay.
Here he is. He scored the first goal for Sparta. Was it easy to beat Ajax today, Ronald?
No, not easy. They have a lot of chances, especially in the first half. But in the second half, we counted very... we hope that we can score a quicker goal. Then Ajax must come. And then you get more space. And that worked all right.
You think it's the same Ajax like the last season?
Yeah, sure. Because if they scored in the first half 3-4 goals, we don't have to say anything.
No. But now...
I think they missed from Boston.
Yeah, I think so too.
They have 4 or 5 really chances.
You know, Barry said in our program of last Friday, no chance for Ajax, we will beat him.
Yeah, but he is always very opportunistic. But we also yesterday kicked the ferry up this week to beat Ajax. And this is lovely for the audience.
And now 5 points.
5 points now, yeah.
So you're heading for European Cup football?
Yeah, that's we're trying always.
Okay, let's go to the dressing room and take some champagne. I think Barry has that.
We'll be back with more Dutch football brought to you.
One and only Barry Hughes, you did it.
Well, I didn't do it, the players did it, but I've got to be a lot of respect for the boys because they kept working in the second half when we were in some bad positions because I thought Ajax played very well on the ball, and then it was just I thought it would be either no goals, but a few boys were tired, you could see it, and then suddenly we got away with Lenkek. And then we scored, and then the crowd started to get behind us, and then you started to get energy, and you started to get
power. That's important, eh?
And then we came again, and we scored again, and then it was we had another couple of chances after that. But, I mean, they had several good chances, but I've got to say, Ed De Gea, our goalkeeper, he played brilliant. And all of them, they all kept working, they kept believing that perhaps we could get a draw, you know. And I thought Ajax, you know, were in control of the game until about the last 10 minutes, and then they just, the heads went, and they started to go, everybody started to go in front of the ball, and we got spacious.
You're making records, Barry. When can we expect the new record of Mr. Barry U?
Well, I hope we're going to start in February. I'll be with you again.
Our Skyviewers didn't hear you sing at all.
No.
So I think we have to do that sometime.
We'll sing the song.
You promise?
I promise.
Okay.
Promise.
Right. A song like My Way or something like that.
My Way, yeah.
Okay.
We'll do it.
Let's celebrate.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Well, singing in the...